Go. Hello, everyone. This is Jonathan Moline, and welcome to another Interviews. And today, I'm going to be interviewing a VTuber, so this will be the first time. And their name is Monolatos Brothers.
Hey, I'm the leader of Monolatos Brothers here. Call me Adrian, and I also do gaming and all animation, Gary's model stuff.
Nice. I like your rig. Your rig's awesome.
Oh, thanks. I've been busy all that time.
All right. So we're going to talk to you about what you do for Twitch and YouTube and what got you in started as a VTuber. So, yeah, that should be the first question I ask you, actually.
Well, let's say 2014. Well, let's say 2015. I began, I was like, Then I began doing a Gary's Mod video from the YouTube, all that stuff. And what I did was I put a Five Nights at Freddy's stage and put my old OCs there and Mega Man there. And that's how I even did the animate, all that stuff. And if it turns out more people reach 1,000 views on my video, I was like, whoa, this is insane. So I decided to continue on that. And it's for the Twitch version. Well, let's just say I did for the Gary's Twitch games. I've been using VTubers like ever since I got a VTuber, so I put the Twitch avatar, and yeah, so that's why I become the VTuber as a Twitch gaming.
That's awesome.
Yep.
So you've been in the game for a long time, since 2014, so you've been on YouTube and Twitch for a long time, so you're almost an OG. Go ahead. Sorry.
Ever since I've become the gaming channel nowadays, so I've been doing a lot of Gary's Mod all day. We did hilarious, I did play Five Nights at Freddy's game, and it was horrifying to me when I was a teenager, and I always got jump scared, all that stuff.
Five Nights at Freddy's. Yeah, that's a good franchise.
True.
Yeah, horror games are, I love playing scary stuff. That's kind of my specialty, but, so is there, any, YouTubers or any out there that inspired you, that got into becoming a VTuber?
I did ask him to begin making the VTuber's Pony OC avatar for in order to make it a special surprise for them, and that's how I made that video. It's called It Is Time, with Mario, Sonic, and all the games on my past gaming, all that stuff. Yeah.
Nice. That's really cool. Like, I could tell by watching your channel, you make some really amazing content, and you have a lot of fun with it, and that's what makes gaming and VTubing fun.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, this is actually really fun. This is the first time I've ever interviewed a VTuber. This is pretty cool.
Yeah, thank you. I've been spent a lot of time making a gaming video, and I did mention that I did the voice of Metal Waters. I did a high voice. I was so embarrassed myself. Everybody's enjoying with my Metal Waters voices for Gary's Mod video. And I was like, oh no, I'm so embarrassed myself, and that's why I had to hide under the blanket.
Okay. Yeah. So okay. Next question. Is there any game franchise you're interested in that you might be playing in the future?
Oh yeah. Well, I've been playing Overwatch series a lot of time, even though it's Overwatch 2. So I've been spending a lot of time for the Twitch streaming, but it depends on any events going on here. So, and of course, playing Fortnite 2 as well. And all the games like Call of Duty and all other games I played as well.
Nice. Yeah, so you played a lot of big games out there. I also play games too every now and then. I did some Let's Playings and stuff. I'm thinking about getting back into it eventually. I play a lot of indie games, so I can give some of the developers of that are trying to get their games more well known. That's why I do Let's Plays, to give more free publicity. But it's a lot of, because I know developing a game takes a lot of time. So it's good that people appreciate people seeing people playing games. But being a YouTuber or a VTuber, like, we always do stuff to interact with the audience, and that's why we come be creatives to get it. If we're doing a VTuber rig, such as yourself, those usually cost a lot of money. Being a YouTuber is not easy because it costs a lot of money and time.
I always got prepared for everything else out there. And you mentioned, I mentioned about the indie games. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I did play The Dark Deception for the first time, but even though I don't have a VTubers model, but now the PS5, I use a VTubers to play Dark Deception demo.
That's cool. Dark Deception. Yeah, that's a good one. I might play that myself sometime soon, actually. There's actually a lot of good ones out there that I've been interested in. I just haven't had the time. Yeah. So, here's another one. Oh my God. My brain can't function today. I like woke up very late.
Oh, how'd that feel?
So, here's another one. Have you ever thought about getting into, have you ever done any like gaming tournaments before? Like, because you're really good. Have you ever thought about getting into gaming tournaments before?
Well, if I ever played any Nintendo's or Overwatch, even Fortnite tournaments around there, but the only problem is for Overwatch games that I had to reach Grandmaster in order to join the tournament. It's including the Fortnites too. I had to pick up the Elite or higher champion.
Nice.
Yeah, but it's gonna take a whole month to reach that rank before I join the tournament. But as for Nintendo, well, even though I don't, it doesn't tell us about this, so I can still join the tournaments anytime.
That's cool. I've been in a couple of tournaments in my past, with Halo and stuff. Me and a group were with Halo 3, played some tournaments. We had a clan and we had a group a long time ago. It was a lot of fun, very challenging. We won some, we lost some. But yeah, I was in competitive gaming before, so it's really more FPSs, like COD. I used to do a lot of competitive COD back in the day. The last COD game I played was the Modern Warfare remake, aka the first Warzone game. I play a lot of multiplayer in that. Got like I got like a this you're gonna love this. I have a recording of getting like a 12 a 20 kill streak in a row. I needed 30 to get the nuke to, win the whole, because that's the ultimate kill thing in that. You get the nuke. Someone shot me and ruined my streak before I can get the nuke. I was like, no.
Well, like every time he's trying to reach the 30 kills in the Modern Warfare, Warzone, Modern Warfare, that it's gonna be impossible. And then, like, you have to hide in the building to wait for the next kill streaks, and you have to prove your skills to get the 30 kill streaks. That I was like, oh, that, and then I had to ask Elijah to help me out.
Yeah, like I was recording like a Let's Play for like I like record like a 20-minute Let's Play, and I did commentary over it. So basically, I was explaining what's going on in the Let's Play, what I did at that time. So it while I'm shooting, getting some really good kill streaks and that, like I used the awesome thing about the newer COD game. They had those humiliations, like the assassination chat. I had like this. To mine was a vampire bat that would come out and like bite people and stuff, and then I'd do a lot of stealth kills, and then I'd pull out like the AK-47, just start shooting people. It was pretty cool. A lot of run in gun, but like you said, yeah, it can get frustrating. Yeah. So, what are some of the? Here's another good one. What is some of the future content you got working on? Like anything new and exciting you want to do? Because I've seen you've done some animations and stuff recently.
Oh yeah, well, I haven't thought about that, any new content I've been planning to do, because I have so many categories I put, like do reaction, vlogs, even gamings, and a reaction. I did a lot of reaction, all the other videos. And I haven't thought about that. I haven't thought about that, because even though I've been playing games or reaction, all the categories I did, including Gacha Live, all stuff. Yeah, I have so many categories. I haven't thought of planned that to announce it yet.
As a yeah. So you do a lot of stuff. Like you're not just sticking to one category. I like that. That's actually what I do is too. As I could say, there's a term for that. You're Adrian, there's a term for that. You're not a one-trick pony.
No, but I have so many categories. I all the categories.
Exactly. Like I do that too. It's like I make short films, make music, do gaming occasionally, voice acting, comic dubs. It's about entertaining people. That's what being a good entertainer is all about. Basically getting your creative freedom out there to the world. Like if you got lots going on in your head, like if you stick to one category for so long, you eventually get bored of it. And then if you want to, then you risk yourself getting trapped into that one category. But it's more like it's always good to come off right from the ghetto, being chaotic as possible, just releasing your creativity to the world to see.
All right.
Yep.
Yep.
It's a pretty good logical theory. So what is like besides gaming and everything, what is like some of your other hobbies you like to do for fun?
Well, a lot of my friends ask me the same question about the hobbies, but I mostly look forward to playing the esports, all that stuff. I was looking forward to play the esports.
Oh, and esports,
Oh,
nice.
esports, nice. Yeah, because I was part of the esports hobby, so that's why I was working so hard to be. I was looking forward to joining the esports gang, like team members. Like, for example, I wore the San Francisco Shaw. I guess you can tell here.
Okay, that's cool.
Yeah, because I was hoping if I could join the San Francisco Shock team someday.
Nice. That's also very cool that your character can wear clothing like that and then it just disappears. That's pretty cool. Oh, man. Oh, sorry. I'm my brain is just thinking of something funny and it's just your character is so awesome. Like it's like every I love how when you talk your character does like a little wink in the eye thing there. That is so cool.
I try my best, cause I try my best.
Yeah, that is so cool. So anyways, Adrian, is there anything else you'd like to talk about before we finish this interview? Is there anything else you'd like to say to everyone?
Everyone. Well, thanks for having me for interviews, all kind of questions. But yeah, thanks for having me.
Yeah, this was actually a lot of fun.
A lot of fun.
All right, well then. Go check out Malonus Brothers, aka Adrian, on his YouTube channel. I will link in the description below and also his Twitch when this video comes out. Till then, stay frosty, my friends, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Markiplier is also my inspiration. Peace.